friends, in this lecture we will talk about jump statements. In our previous lectures we had seen what are selection statements and iteration or looping statements. A selection statement helps you to select a particular execution path based on a condition which may be true or false, while a looping statement helps you to execute a set of statements repeatedly as long as the specified condition is true. In this lecture we will talk about the third type of control statement, that is the jump statement. There are two types of jump statements. They are break and continue statement. So first we'll see what are break statements. A break statement is used to terminate a loop or a switch statement, and it can be used along with a do while or a for loop, any kind of loop, and a switch statement also. The break statement is simply written as break followed by a semicolon, and you need not specify any expression or statement along with break. In case of a nested loop, it will terminate only the immediately enclosing loop. That is, it will not terminate all the loops within which it is present. It will only terminate the innermost or the loop which immediately encloses it. Next is the continue statement. A continue statement helps you to skip the remaining portion of the loop. A break statement will help you to terminate the loop, but continue statement will never terminate the loop. It will just skip the remaining portion of the loop. It is simply written as continue followed by a semicolon without any embedded statement or expression. And the most important difference here between break and continue is that continue will never terminate your loop, and continue statement can only be used with a loop, with loops like for, do while or while loop. So this was about break and continue statements. Now we'll talk about labeled breaks and labeled continue. So a labeled break will help you to break out of one or more blocks. So it overcomes the limitation of the break statement. The break statement will only break out of the immediately enclosing loop, but it will not break out of more than one loops. So labeled break can be used for that purpose, and it can be used independently with the help of a label. Label indicates where the control is to be transferred after the execution of the statement. That is, it will specify where the execution should resume after the statement is executed, and its general format is break label. And the label here is an identifier which identifies the block from where the control is to be transferred. And so when the statement executes, the control will be transferred out of that block. And one more thing here is that this statement break label or the labeled break must be compulsorily enclosed inside the block with the same label. Okay, let's look at this example. Here example one is the block. You can label the block by simply writing the identifier followed by a colon. So example one is a block, and inside which I have written two for loops. So the first for loop will execute for I is 1 till I is 3. So when I is 1, j is 1, and again it will print 1. In the next pass it will print 2. Now in the next pass j is 3. Now if j is 3, it will execute the statement break example 1. That is, it will directly break out of the entire block. So you will get the output something like 1, 2. No other pass will be executed after this statement, because the label break helps you to break out of more than one block. So this was about labeled break. Next is labeled continue. Now this labeled continue will help you to execute the next pass of the loop. That is, it will not directly break out of the loop, it will continue with the next execution of the labeled loop. We'll understand this when we look at the example. And this is the main difference between labeled continue and labeled break, that labeled continue will continue with the next execution of the loop. And another difference is that it has to be used with a loop. It cannot execute without a loop. Okay, while a labeled break can execute independently without a switch or a loop. So its general format is continue label. This is the labeled continue statement, and it has to be enclosed in the block with the same label. So let us look at this example. This is the same example we had seen for labeled continue, except that we have specified continue here instead of break. So we will try to recall in labeled break, the break example one used to break out of the entire all the loops, in fact the entire block. So in case of continue, labeled continue, it will not break out of all the loops. What it will do, it will just continue with the next execution of the labeled loop. It will skip the remaining passes and continue with the next execution. Let us try to understand what does this mean. For I is 1, it will execute this for loop. For j is 1, it will print 1. For j is 2, it will print 2. Now for j is 3, this statement is encountered, continue example 1. Now this will not break out of all the loops, it will just break out of the j loop, and it will go to the next pass of I. Now again I is 2, then it will come inside, and here j is 1, so it will print 1. Again j is 2, it will print 2. Now j is 3, again it will skip the remaining passes, go back to I, third pass of I. And again it will execute j is 1, print j is 2, print j. After that it will go back and it will see I is, since I becomes 4, it will stop the execution and will get the output as 1 2 1 2 1 2. So this was about labeled continue and labeled break. I hope you all understood. And please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. Thank you for watching the video.